Last class we discussed about different properties: reflexive property, symmetric property, and transitive property. A relation satisfying these properties are consecutively mentioned as reflexive relation, symmetric relation, and transitive relation. A relation, if it satisfies all these three properties, then we call it as equivalence relation. All these things we just discussed in the last class. And as I mentioned you, reflection property. The name itself is suggesting there must be a reflection in the ordered case. That in the sense, every element of the set, just it is connected to the same element of the same set. Just like X connects to X, Y connects to Y, Z connects to X, Z, like that. For every element of the given set, if the element is connected to itself, then we say the relation is reflexive relation. And whenever we say a relation as symmetric, if there is an ordered pair x comma y in the relation, then you need to check for y comma x. If it is there in the relation, it is symmetric, or otherwise not symmetric. Then coming to transitive relation, see, first suppose if you have two ordered pairs xy and yz, once again I am repeating xy, where the first ordered pair second element is y and the second ordered pair first element is y, xy and yz, then the rule must be transferred from x to z. Since the rule is transferring, we call it as transitive property. If we have ordered pairs xy and yz, then we need to search for xz. If xz is also there in the relation, that is transitive, or otherwise not transitive. So I mentioned all these properties with a few examples in the last class. And now just look at the board. This is the 11th point. Here R is the relation on the set X having elements A, B, C. Then we need to check for these properties. What are the properties? Reflexive, symmetric, transitive. Okay. So as we discussed for many times, here X, N of X is equals to 3. Since N of X is equals to 3, then N of X cross X. Okay. Then the Cartesian product. Okay, actually my set is X, right? So X cross X, N of X cross X contains 9 elements. So the number of relations are 2 power 9. They are 512. So there are 512 relations from X on X. So just I am mentioning some examples here. Okay. I have few examples. I named those relations as R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6 with the ordered pairs as my intention. Okay. So you need to consider each and every relation and you need to check these three properties. Which property is satisfied by these relations? Okay. So for suppose if you consider the first relation, you need to check whether reflexive is satisfying or not. You need to check about symmetry. You need to check about transitive property. And all those things you need to check. Okay. So for the first R1, just I will discuss, I will check it. And then I will leave you some time to think about the remaining relations. Okay. First of all, you just look at the relation R1. R1 is a relation on X having the ordered pairs AA, BB, CC, BC. Okay. My intention first is to check reflexive property. So, since X contains the elements A, B, C, to say a relation as reflexive, that relation must contain ordered pair AA, ordered pair BB, ordered pair CC. Here I have those three elements. So, for sure I say this relation is satisfying reflexive property. Right. Then symmetric. So if xy is there, then we need to search for the interchange of the element yx. AA, interchange AA. BB, interchange BB. CC, if you interchange CC. BC, if you interchange, that will become CB. BC is there in the relation, but if you interchange, what you say? CB is not there here in R1. So that's why this first relation is not symmetric. Is it clear? Reflexive, okay, but it is not symmetric. Then what you say about transitive? So for transitive, first of all, you need to consider two ordered pairs of the relation such that like xy and yz. So just look there, AA. Then no ordered pair is there starting with A. BB. I have one ordered pair starting with BC. So BB and another ordered pair starting with BC. So if you, this B and B common, if you transfer the property, then again the resultant ordered pair is BC. That BC is again there in this relation. So this pair of ordered pairs satisfying transitive property. And I need to check for another order pair, okay? CC, but no element is there which starting with C. BC, since it is BC, okay? I have an ordered pair starting with C and which is CC. And again, if you transfer that property, again you will get that BC. Still it is there in the same relation. So, again the transferring is happened here. And that's why this first relation is transitive also. Just once again think about the relation. The first relation R1 is reflexive. The first relation R1 is transitive. And the first relation R1 is not symmetric. Why it is not symmetric? Since BC is there, but CB is not there. Okay. So, the discussion about the first relation is completed. Related to the reflexive, symmetric and transitive properties. And then, now you need to think about these remaining relations. Which are reflexive, which are symmetric and which are transitive and everything. Okay. You just take 3 to 4 minutes time. Okay. And then again I will discuss the remaining relations. Okay. Just first of all you just think about it. So just look at the board. So first one is clear. Just I discussed it. Okay. Then coming to the second one. See if you look there, AA, BB are there in the set in the relation R2. But CC is not there. Since CC, C is not connected to C, so it is not reflexive. And whereas coming for the symmetric, take every ordered pair and it's a interchanging of the elements. Like BC is there, if you interchange CB is also there. It happens for every ordered pair and that's why it is symmetric. And whereas coming for the transitive, just look there. BC, CB. So BB is there here. BB, BC. BC is also there here. Okay, if you check the transitive property also as we discussed in first R1, it is transitive also. Okay, then coming to R3. So AA, BB, CC. Three ordered pairs are not there for reflexive. So not reflexive. AB is there but BA is not here. So not symmetric. Coming to transitive, AB, BC and then AC. So if B is common and then A to C is transferring the property. And that's why it is transitive. Okay. There is no other pair of ordered pairs where the transferness is failed. Since it is not there, so it is transitive. Then the next one, AA, BB, CC are there reflexive. And it is also transitive. BC is there, but CB is not there like this. So it is not symmetric. Then coming to the next one, AA, BB, CC are given. So this is reflexive. And whereas coming for the symmetric, BC and its what interchanging of the elements, CB is also there. So it is even symmetric and also transitive. Then whereas coming for the last one, AA, A is related to A, but BB and CC are not there. And that's why it is not reflexive. Whereas coming for the transitive, A symmetric, right? Symmetric. AB is there, but BA is not there. So it is not symmetric. Then coming to transitive. A, B, B, C. B is a common thing and you need to transfer from A to C and then A to C is also not here, so it is not transitive. Just look there. Just look once again. Okay. The last relation is not reflexive, not symmetric, not transitive. And before that one is all reflexive, symmetric and transitive. R4 is just not symmetric. R3 is just transitive but it is not symmetric, not reflexive. And R2, it is both symmetric and transitive but not reflexive. And whereas coming to R1, it is not symmetric and it is reflexive as well as transitive. So likewise, there is a chance to frame the relations depending on this. Okay. For suppose I ask you, just frame a relation where which is both reflexive and symmetric but not transitive. Here if you look there, see, we have transitive property for all the relations. Okay. I am asking you for both reflexive and symmetric relation which is not transitive. So, there is a chance to frame like that also. Okay. I will give you some more questions in 12B related to that. And before going to discuss those type of questions, first think about these six relations once again. And if you have any doubts related to this, just once again, just look at R4. I mentioned it as trans 2, but it is not trans 2 actually. Okay, just once discuss about that R4. Okay, see, AA, BB, CC are here, so this is reflexive. Very good. Then to check symmetric, for every ordered pair, we need to have that interchanging of the elements. AA, BB, CC, BC is there. If you interchange it, CB is not there, so it is not symmetric. Then coming to trans 2, look at these two ordered pairs, BC and CA. Here C is the common thing, and to say it as trans 2, that transfer from B to A, that means ordered pair BA. We need to check for that ordered pair BA, if it is there in R4 or not. If that BA is there in R4, we say it is trans 2. But this ordered pair BA is not there in R4, and that's why this is not trans 2. Okay, so at the end, the relation R4 is just reflexive, not symmetric, as well as not trans 2. Okay, just have a look. So in 11b, we need to frame certain relations. Okay, that means we need to give examples for one example is for a relation which is reflexive, symmetric, but not trans 2. And another example for a relation which is symmetric but not reflexive and transitive. Usually many possibilities are there for this. You just mention any one example for each. Look at the board once. Okay, so the first relation is reflexive, symmetric but not transitive, and the second relation is not reflexive since CC is not there, is for sure symmetric, and it is not transitive. Okay, you just try for your own examples once again. Okay, there are many possibilities to say the examples. You just try once again. Once again at the end, 11C. So again, I have few examples. The first one is set containing AA, BB, CC, and then empty relation, and then universal relation, and then singleton elemented relations. So where a relation contains only one ordered pair. Okay, so we need to check about the properties of these relations. First one, AA, BB, CC. So AA, BB, CC, our discussion is based on the set X where the elements are ABC. For every element of X, like A, like B, like B, like C, its connection AA, BB, CC is there in this relation. So this is reflexive. And what you say about symmetric? See, already for every relation, the interchanging like are also there here, so it is also symmetric. Then it is also transitive. I already mentioned you to say whether relation is transitive or not. First of all, we need to search for a pair of ordered pairs where the second element of the first ordered pair and the first element of the second ordered pair should equal. Okay, so that chance only is not possible in this relation. So there is no chance here to check about transitive property. Since there is no chance to check, we need to say it as trans 2. Then coming to the empty relation. Since it is empty, clearly these type of elements like AA, BB are not there in this relation, so it is not reflexive. And what you say about symmetric? See, to check whether a relation is symmetric or not, you need to start with an ordered pair of the relation. But here no ordered pairs are there, and that's why we say it as symmetric. And for sure it is trans 2. And universal relation. Universal relations means all the ordered pairs in X cross X are there in this relation. We call it as universal relation. And that universal relation again, for sure it is what? Reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. Whereas singleton elemented relations, like only one ordered pair is in that relation. So if you think about such relations, okay, there is only one ordered pair actually. But there are three elements in the given set X. So if we have at least three ordered pairs like AA, BB, CC, then we say it as reflexive. But these sets, these relations have only one ordered pair, for sure they are not reflexive. And for sure they are not symmetric. Why? Because one ordered pair is there, but its reverse thing is not located. Okay, that in the sense, one more classification. See, these type of elements are not reflexive, but symmetric. Why? Because if you interchange the elements, Again, AA is there in that relation. And but these type of ordered pairs, not reflexive as well as not symmetric. But both the types of singleton sets are transitive because there are no chance to check. Okay, since there is no chance to check whether they are transitive or not, we need to say it as transitive. Once again, I am repeating. If there is no chance to check, say it as transitive. If there is a chance to check, check it. And if you correct with the checking, say it as transitive. If you are not correct with the checking, then say it as again not transitive. Okay? Yes, once again, look all these things. 11c, some more relations on X and their properties, which are reflexive, which are symmetric, which are transitive and everything. Okay? So just think about the reflexive, symmetric and transitive property. Okay? Get a full length command on all these things. Okay?